Another question people always ask me about Grandma's Boy is, what was it like having sexual relations with that older lady? Yeah. My response is, not the first time with an older lady. Which is true, and that's another story I'm going to share with you. This is a 100% true story that happened to me when I was 19 years old. Used to live in New York City. Moved there from Minnesota, where I'm from. Yeah, Minnesota. I was like really naive. I grew up really like kind of sheltered a little bit. So I moved to New York and it was like pretty intense and it was a lot of crazy shit. So my buddy calls me up one day. He's like, hey, what are you doing? I'm like, nothing, what are you doing? He goes, hey, you wanna come with me? I'm gonna go get a massage. And I'm like, what? I'm like, why do you want a massage? I'm like, are you stressed out or something? Like, how much is that? I'm like, I'm not gonna pay for, I'm like, I don't know, is your back fucked up? And he's like, no, dummy. He's like, they jerk you off at the end of it. And I'm like, yes, I wanna get a massage. Why are we not there every day? Why don't I live above that place? So we go to this place, my buddy has an address, he's never been there. Someone just gave him this address. So we're walking through the neighborhood and it's starting to get like really bad and sketchy. So I turn to my friend, I'm like, dude, this is not a good neighborhood. He's like, it's fine, it's fine. So we find the address that he has written down. It's an abandoned building, fully abandoned. Like windows busted out and boarded up. I'm like, this is not good. And he's like, don't be a pussy, man. Let's go in. I'm like, we're not on Scooby-Doo, okay, I mean? I'm not gonna be like, let's go into the building. There's no way it's haunted. So he talks me into it. He's like, come on. So we go into the building, still abandoned. It's a real shocker. Still abandoned, and we're looking around. I'm like, we gotta get out of here. And he goes, no, wait, look. In the corner, there's a door. On the door is a piece of paper taped to the door. And in pen, somebody wrote, spa. And my buddy's like, see, there it is. Like, oh yeah, everything's great now. Terrible, so we Scooby-Doo it into the door. We go downstairs, full on, I shit you not, brand new Asian spa. Brand new, like amazing. I was like, are you kidding me? It was all Asian, which is awesome. Of course, they know what they're doing. So we walk down and we're like, this is crazy. So we check in at this like front desk, get robes, we go into this lounge area, and these girls would come out and take people like into the back. So this 18-year-old girl walks out, super cute, walks out, what's that? Could have been 12, I don't know, Asian girls look young. They look young! No, just kidding. 18-year-old girl walks out, takes my friend away, he's all fired up. He's like, yeah, motherfucker, I told you! Another 18-year-old girl, smoking hot, takes this other guy away. I'm on the on-deck circle. This woman comes out, maybe 70. Comes out, big woman, like just like comes bounding out. Look like E. Honda from Street Fighter, just like. Oh, you get. She comes out, I'm like, oh my God. Takes me by the hand, and I'm all confused and scared now. I'm like, are we going to get your daughter? Hopefully. So we start walking to the back area, and I panic. I'm like, let's just do the massage. Let's not do the end thing, blah, blah, blah. This is weird. But she doesn't speak any English. She's just like, okay, yeah. I'm just kind of going along with it, so I'm not sure if she's getting it. So I lie down, naked on the bed, oiled up. She starts giving me a massage. It's awesome. Obviously, she's been doing it for 1,000 years. She knows like every little thing. So she starts doing my back. Then she would whisper into my ear. But it wasn't English, it was Chinese. She'd be like, so I don't know what she's saying, but I don't want to be rude. So I just agree. Which is never good when you don't know what the fuck someone's saying. I was just like, yeah. She could have been like, kill your family? Yeah, all right, I don't know, sure. So I just agree. So then she would start doing my legs. Then she whispered in my ear, hey, go, let me do yoga. I'm like, yeah. She started doing my arms. So this goes back and forth for a couple times. Does it one more time. I'm like, yeah. In one motion, flips me over, grabs my dick, and just starts fucking jerking me off. Like, it was like weird Matrix, like, it was insane. Just going to town. But it wasn't even like comfortable. It was just like, she was like attacking it. Like, so I was like, I wanted a hand job and she's playing fucking Wii tennis. Just like, I'm like, what is happening? So it's horrifying and I'm trying to figure out what to do. Cause I can't get into it cause she's fighting me. She's fighting my dick. So, at this point, I don't want to hurt her feelings. So now I feel bad, and I start thinking about her, like, from her perspective. And I'm like, this poor woman, she's older. I bet nobody comes to see her. Everyone's freaked out when they do see her. She gets no repeat customers. She probably has kids and grandkids, great-grandkids. Great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great situation. I'm like, wait, stop. And she's like, oh, bad. And I was like, felt really guilty. I'm like, no, good. And then so we're just standing there and I'm like, no, I'll just do it. I'll do it. So now I have to jerk off while she watches me. Not only does she watch me, she starts cheering me on. Totally true. So I'm like trying to focus and she's like, good. And I was just like, not helping. I appreciate what you're trying to do. Yeah. I'm really glad that story is now on TV forever. My entire family will see that.
Nicholas, I saw a story about you.
I'm excited for the summer. I like summer movies. I'm a big fan. I like big blockbustery. I'm like a nerd like that. Like movies like Transformers, I love that shit. I love that stuff. Like, I hate it, like, so many people are jaded now. Does anybody here have jaded movie friends? Or like, they go to movie, like, they can't fucking like any movie. It's so annoying. I'm like, dude, I just saw Transformers, that was sick. Yeah, I saw it, bro. Sucked. Dude, it was kinda cool. Nah, sucked. Yeah, but that one scene, dude, saw it, sucked. It's like, people are so jaded. Like, it still looks cool, you know what I mean? Like, if you showed that movie 50 years ago, people would be like, ah! Their brains would explode. Ah! Everybody would lose their minds. They'd be out in the streets just stabbing each other. It would be chaos if you showed Transformers in, like, 1950. People now are like, yep, boo. Like, God, you can't appreciate anything. I always thought it'd be funny, though, if in a movie like that, if just to mess with all the stone people in the crowd at the theater, if right before the movie started, like Transformers, they just put, based on a true story. When the fuck did that happen? Are you kidding me? That happened? How did that happen? Are you serious? Oh my God. That's terrifying. Yeah, I always think of weird shit like that. I always think it would be funny too, because I always like movie previews before the movie, you know, the little trailers. I always like those. But I always think it'd be funny if they showed a really dramatic trailer, really serious, right? And they have a title at the end of it that has nothing to do with the trailer. Just again, to mess with the audience. So really dramatic movie trailer, title doesn't make any sense. So they come on like, coming this fall, the story of a family brutally torn apart, the father killed in a horrible accident, the mother forced to raise 8 children on her own. In a cruel world, all they have is each other. Coming this fall from the producers of Philadelphia and the director of Castaway comes Boner Soup.
People are like, what? That movie's called Boner Soup? About the dad who died of the kids? What the fuck is Boner Soup? Boner Soup. I didn't see a boner or soup in the whole trailer. What is that? Is it one thing? I don't want to see that.